verse 3. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1 to verse 3. The Bible says, now faith is being sure of what we hope and certain of what we do. This is what the essence were commanded for. By faith we understand that the universe was formed at God's command, so that what is seen was not made out of what was visible. By faith, Abel... No, I want to end from verse 3. The Bible says, faith is being sure of what we hope. Faith is being sure of what we hope, but it is not seen.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Now, we have got the definition of faith. If I tell you something, what are you sure of? Are you sure of owning your own car? Or are you sure of owning your own house? What are you sure of? There are some people here who are sure of owning their car, like Prado, Vitz, Hammer, Land Rover, among others. But there are some other people who are here, but they have a faith of owning. You know, faith, it depends on the level of your faith. The level of your faith will determine what you are going to get, what you are going to own.
Amen.
Other people here have faith of owning tractors. That's their faith. Other people here have faith of owning bicycles, motorcycles. That is faith. But do you have faith?
Amen.
To what extent your faith is now? I just wanted to know if people here have faith in their prophetess. You might be here, but you are not sure of her. But I want to remove that wall. I want to remove it out.
Amen.
I want to command that wall to come out.
Amen.
Because this is the servant of God.
Yes.
And God has set up her in motion in order to deliver her people.
Amen.
Yes. Prophetess is here normally to take you from one stage to another stage.
Yes.
From bad, poor condition to better, to better living condition.
Amen. Now,
let's read the book of Matthew. Want to read the book of Matthew, chapter 17. Matthew chapter 17, verse 20 to 21. The Bible says, verse 20, he replied, because you have so little faith, I tell you the truth, if you have faith as small as mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. When they come together in Galilee, he said to them, the Son of Man is going to be betrayed into the hands of men. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible says, because you have so little faith, you can tell this mountain to move and it will move. What is a mountain today? You can tell that mountain of yours to move from here to there and it will move. You can tell the disease in your body to get out and it will get out.
Amen.
You can tell the sufferings, yes, to move and it will move.
Yes.
What is needed here is to have faith.
Amen.
Have faith. The Bible says in the book of Chronicles, 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 20, section B, have faith in the Lord your God and you'll be upheld. Have faith in his prophets and you'll be successful.
Amen.
If you have faith in your prophetess, that means each and every mountain in your life, it will move.
Amen.
If you command it to move out, it, yes, must move out.
Yes.
It does not matter the situation you are passing through, but the mountain must move out if you just have a mere faith. Having faith in the Lord's servants, you'll be successful in your life. What's your mountain today? You can tell your disease to move out and it will move. You can tell even HIV to move and it will move.
Amen.
You can tell cancer to move and it moves.
Amen.
You can tell it, even if it's the flu, you can tell it to move out and it will move out.
Amen.
Even you can talk that poverty of yours. Perhaps some other people here are suffering from poverty,
yes,
starvation,
yes,
calamities,
yes,
disasters,
mm,
problems and troubles. Conflict does not end in your life. But Jesus said, if you have faith,
yes,
if you have faith,
mm,
little faith,
yes,
like a mustard seed. A mustard seed, this is the smallest seed in the world. Sometimes you cannot see it by normal eyes, by physical eyes. Maybe if you use microwatch, if you use something else that can zoom in it and you can see. But mustard seed is the smallest seed in the world. Now, Jesus just compared the mustard seed. If you have a little faith like mustard seed, just like mustard seed, you can talk to that problem and it will move. You can talk to anything that disturbs you and it will move out of your body. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
Mustard seed. I'm talking about faith. This faith, having faith, you may have faith, but you won't succeed in life. Perhaps your faith is solid, but just hope in the God's prophetess. Just hope in the servants of God and you'll be successful in life.
Amen.
This is what Bible says. This is what the Bible has commanded to us to do.
Yes.
If we have faith,
yes,
in his prophets,
amen.
The Bible says in his prophets, not pastors, not teachers, but
yes,
in his prophets,
yes,
you will be successful.
Amen.
And here most of our prophetess,
yes,
we shall be successful if we have faith on her.
Amen.
If we believe on her, we shall be successful.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, I want to read the Bible of Ezekiel. Ezekiel chapter 37 from verse 1. Ezekiel 37 from verse 1. The Bible says, the hand of the Lord was upon me, and he brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord, and set me in the middle of the valley. It was full of bones. He led me back and forth among them, and I saw a great many bones on the floor of the valley, bones that were very dry. He asked me, Son of man, can these bones live? Hear the word of the Lord. This is what the sovereign Lord says to these bones. I will make breath enter you, and you come to life. But let me end from here. God commanded Ezekiel, this was a prophet. God told Ezekiel, can these bones live? These bones was in the floor. These bones were in the floor of the valley. Now, Lord took Ezekiel to the valley,
yes,
and he saw many bones, and he told him, can these bones live? Sin? Can these dry bones live? Sin? Can your dry business again live?
Yes.
I'm talking to you.
Yes.
Can that body of yours that is affected by diseases can live it again?
Yes.
By the word of God, of course it can live, because God,
yes,
has given us authority,
yes,
and powers,
uh-huh,
to prophesy.
Oh yes.
Yes. By the way, if you want to be prophesied, when I was coming here the first time, I remember the servants of God was here preaching, was here leading the prayers. And he told us, if you want to be prophesied by the prophetess, first prophesy for yourself.
Amen.
If you have nothing to prophesy, by the way,
yes,
God, may your prophetess, as she stands there on this altar,
yes,
the first prophecy is mine.
Amen.
Yes.
I urge everybody, just as you are sitting there, prophesy to yourself. Prophesy, can I have a better healthy? Can I have good condition, good living condition? Can I have better and good cars?
Yes.
Prophesy,
yes,
to yourself. As you said, don't even stand up, just prophesy. But if you have nothing to prophesy, just say, God, When my mama stands here, I want her. The first prophecy is mine.
Yes.
Prophesy for yourself.
Oh, yes.
Prophesy for yourself as you are seated. Not even stand up. Just prophesy. I want to go in health. I want good health condition. I want to own my own cars. I don't want to own. Some people here have faith just of owning tractors. Have faith of owning hammer and drovers and.
Oh, yes. 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 Yes.
Have faith of owning these small things. You're not in that level, my dear.
Amen.
Otherwise, you'll just be there. Tampering with that life of yours, and the time goes on, you'll be in the same level.
Oh yes.
I urge everybody to just prophesy for yourself. What do you want today?
Amen.
God commanded Ezekiel to prophesy to this bones. Can this dry bones live? Can you live again? Can that body of yours that is affected by the diseases live again? Can you live again? Now I want to proceed. Verse 7. The Bible says, verse 6, I will attach tendons to you and make flesh come upon you and cover you with skin. I will put breath in you and you will come to life. Then you will know that I am the Lord. So I prophesied as I was commanded. Ezekiel, when he was told by God to prophesy to these dry bones, he did not deny. Of course, he prophesied. He said, can you talk to these bones and the tendon will attach again? Do you understand?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Are we together?
Yes.
Can you prophesy to these dry bones?
Yes.
And the tendon will attach again. That's what the Bible says. Now I want to proceed. Verse 7. So I prophesied as I was commanded, and I was prophesying. There was a noise of rattling sound, and these bones came together, bone to bone. And these bones came together, bone to bone. Remember the first, when you read in the first verse, the Bible says, was taken by God to the valley. When he went there, he found many bones on the floor of the valley, but they were separated. When he was told, Ezekiel, can these bones live again and become normal human beings? He said, Lord, you know. And that's why some of us will say, yeah, Lord, you know, so if I can prosper in this life, if I can own my own car, if I can have my own business, If I can own my own house. So Ezekiel here in verse 7, the Bible says he prophesied as he was told, and the bones came together, bone to bone. Now there is going to make a normal flesh. Let's proceed. I looked, and tendons and flesh appeared on them, and skin covered them, but there was no breath in them. He used the faith to command the bones and bones to come together.
Amen.
And the skin, yes, covered those bones. Now, there is going to make a normal human being by faith. Only by faith. He said by faith. Remember, this is faith. And today we're studying about faith.
Amen.
He told the bones to come together and to kill. But the Bible says, but there was no life because there was no breath of God. Let's proceed. Verse 9. The Bible says, then he said to me, prophesy to the breath, prophesy, son of man, and say to it, this is what the sovereign Lord says, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe into this slain, and they may live. So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath entered them. They came to life and stood up on their feet. Ezekiel, again, he was told to prophesy the breath to come. Remember, it was just a mere normal bodies, flesh bodies, but those bodies were not alive because there was no breath. So God again commanded Ezekiel to prophesy on those bodies so that they can be normal human being, living human being. So when he prophesied, the Bible says it came, the Bible says, verse 9, section B. This is what the sovereign Lord says. Come from four winds, or breathe. Ezekiel commanded breathe to come from north, from east, west, and south. And it came. And the breath came and covered the body. Now it became the full living body. By then it was just a mere bodies. They were just a mere bodies, but they weren't living bodies. But now when he prophesied breathe, and breath came and it entered in, again it became human beings. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are we together?
Amen.
We're starting the work of faith. Of faith.
Yes.
Faith.
Yes.
Gives us the faith gives us the power of talking. You can talk to anything that is that seems to be dead, but it may come to live again.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now let me proceed. I'm going to proceed up to chapter 13. The Bible says, in verse 10, the Bible says, so I prophesied as you commanded me, and the breath entered them. They came life and stood up on their feet. A vast army. Then he said to me, son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They say, our bones are dried up, and our hope is gone. We are cut off. Therefore, prophesy and say to them, see, this is what the sovereign Lord says, oh my people, I am going to open your graves and bring you up from them. I will bring you back to the land of Israel. Then you, my people, will know that I am the Lord. When I open your graves and bring you up from them, I will put my spirit in you and you will live. And I will settle you in your own land. Then you will know that I, the Lord, have spoken and I have done it, declares the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, when Ezekiel had already prophesied about the breath, and the breath entered into the bodies, the Bible says it became the first army. This was a big army of Israel has ever been before. Amen.
Amen.
Now I want to shift from the book of Ezekiel to book of 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, chapter 13, verse 1-8. 1 Corinthians. Chapter 13, verse 1. The Bible says, here I want to teach you. At the first time I was telling that how faith comes, but here, where faith comes. Faith comes from love.
Yes.
Without love, there is no faith at all. Without love, you can command nothing, and it will happen, and nothing will happen. Now, I want to show the relationship between faith and love. Now, listen. The Bible says in the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 13, verse 1. The Bible says, "If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or clanging cymbal." If I have the gift of prophesy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains but have no love, I'm nothing. If I give all I possess to poor and surrender my body to the flames but have no love, again, nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no records of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but it rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always preserves. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. Will never come to pass. And if it will come to pass, it will come to pass in delay. Not in time, but on time. Love and faith interferes, it interferes each other. Love and faith works together.
Yes.
If you have faith in something and you don't love it, let's assume that you may have faith in the prophetess, but you don't love her. I'm telling the fact you'll never prosper in your life if you don't love her. You have first to love her.
Yes.
You have first to love her the way she is.
Amen.
Then your preface will come to pass.
Amen.
Faith without love and action is nothing.
Yes.
She has prophesied. Of course, when she prophesied, that means that she has already seen it in vision.
Yes.
And that must come to pass.
Yeah.
When she told her that, I'm seeing a car for you. Then you go back and sleep. Even if you love her, you go back and sleep. But she has prophesied to you that next year by this time, you're going to have, or you're going to own your own car.
Yes.
You have to work hard so that you can achieve in what she prophesied to you.
Yes.
Prophecy.
Yes.
Prophecy.
Mm.
Without action.
Yes.
Prophecy. Mm. Without love, it will never come true in your life.
Mm.
So, faith, love, and action work together to make your prophecy to be fulfilled to what the prophetess has prophesied to you.
Boy,
now. I want to tell you this. You may love your prophetess, but there are so many ways of loving somebody.
Yes.
You may love her because she's beautiful, of course she is.
Yeah.
Yes, because she's beautiful, but if she wasn't, then you couldn't love her. You may love her. You don't love her because she's a spiritual mother. No. You may love her in any way.
Yes.
But the only way which can make you to succeed in your life,
yes,
when it comes to prophetess, you have to love her as your spiritual mom,
yes,
as your seer,
uh-huh,
as your leader, as your controller,
yes,
as a person who sees before you.
Amen.
Now, if you don't love her as your spiritual mom, that means even the prophecy that she goes to prophesy for you,
yes,
will come to pass by delay or later. So what's the work of love? Work of love is to pump the faith that you have in you.
Okay.
That love, when it pumps your faith,
mm-hmm,
and you have faith in somebody and love, that means that the prophecy that she has prophesied for you, it will come to pass.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to go to somebody here.
Yes.
I want to go to somebody here.
Yes.
I want to show you. You cannot. The Bible says, love is patient. Love keeps no wrong records. Love does not keep wrong records at all. There are some people, okay, you have faith in her, you love her. But when it happens that it is like this, there are some people have this habit, oh man, as I can say. When the prophetess comes, when he already she's delivering people, she might, of course she's a human being, she kind of scratch her hair. But she does not know by then. And you see people falling down because of deliverance.
Yes.
When you come out, you start to say, this prophetess, my God, bless. She came, she just held her head like this and people started falling down. Faith does not keep wrong records. She's a human being, of course, and she has to scratch her hair, she has to touch wherever she wants.
Yes.
But have faith in her and have love in her. but does not give, don't keep wrong records on her.
Oh yes.
That's about, I want to make this point clear.
Yes.
Do not take her in a wrong way or in a bad direction where will make your prophets to pass later or to pass in delay.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
I want to talk to somebody.
Yes.
Says, love is patient.
Yes.
Love is kind.
Uh-huh.
And love, it, let me read. The Bible says in verse 4, love is patient. Love is kind. It does not keep any. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. If you love somebody, you cannot keep no record of wrongs on that person. That will be, that is not again love.
Yes.
That is what we call hatred. Are we together?
Amen.
Are we together?
Amen.
Now, I want to show you, if you want to be successful in your life,
yes,
have faith,
uh-huh,
have love,
uh-huh,
and action.
Yes.
So your life will be, you will have a prosperity life,
uh-huh,
and succeed in your life.
Yes.
What does the Bible say? The Bible says,
uh-huh,
have faith in the Lord your God and you'll be upheld, you'll be established.
Yes.
But have faith in his prophets, you'll be successful.
Amen.
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 I'll urge everybody to stand up as I'm finishing this last part, this last book. The book of the name of Jesus Christ's name.
Amen.
Have faith, you'll be successful in your life.
I receive.
I command prosperity in your life.
Amen.
I be successful in your life.
Amen.
Better living condition in your life in Jesus Christ.
I receive.
I urge everybody to stand up. Stand up on your feet. Stand up on your feet. I was going to finish this. Please, I want everybody to know what is faith and what is love. And faith, when you add faith and love and action, you'll get successful life. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
I want everybody to say, oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Lord of my mother prophetess Esther.
Lord of my mother prophetess
Esther. Increase the level of my faith.
Increase the level of my faith.
I want to go to the next level.
I want to go to the next level.
I want prosperity life.
I want prosperity life.
I want to own each and everything in my own hands.
I want to hold each and everything in my own hands.
I want everybody to pray to God that he may give Seek faith. No, I want you to seek faith to God so that you may be successful in your life.